massive relay. What's going on here? You got the system for total control. Now is there anybody out there? Now watch yourself for you, cause we can't go. What is it really that is in your head? One little life that you had just died. I'm gonna be the one that's taking over. Now this is what it's like when worlds collide.
Good evening, everybody. We're back just to put over one of the best shows that you've ever seen, Planet Wrestling. I'll tell you what, our first show was a huge success.
There was a smile on the face of everyone in attendance at the Loxley Civic Center. I have to say, it was probably one of the best shows I've ever been to in my life. One of the best events ever.
You know what? Let me just tell you something. I even had some of the wrestlers call up and say, you know what? That was fun. We had a good time. And I'm going to tell you, if the wrestlers are in there having a good time, beating the brains out of whoever, then you know what? The fans are going to have a good time.
I agree.
And, you know, but before we get started, I've got to put this out on the table. You had called me up and said, Bobby, come over, you know, because we got to have you on the TV because that's what brings people in. So I came over and I see that you brought... You know what, your little monkey with you here.
This is one of the co-owners of Planet
totally
Wrestling.
I totally understand that. You know, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cheif Iron Claw.
You know, what we got over here, well, what is the gin? A talking platypus. That's what we got over here, a talking platypus. And you know, I would have to say, some of the staff, hush, Bobby, I'm talking right now. Some of the staff is trying to suck ice cream through a straw right now, and I want to tell you, it is amazing.
It is.
You know, she just threw the straw down, and she's using the spoon.
Before we get started on this
pure disaster, because you're here, first off, we have to thank our sponsors. Now, somebody said, and I have to say this, we mentioned our sponsors too much, because you see, it ain't about the sponsors, it's about putting other people over. Well, let me tell you, if it wasn't for the sponsors there, little backyarder, we wouldn't have a show. So,
Now, wait a minute, Bobby, let's be polite to all the little backyarders. We don't need to be mean to them guys that's never been trained.
And yet this will be edited out anyway, so see, there you go.
We need to be better. We're going to set an example. For all the backyarders. You know what I'm saying?
We got to set an example
for the backyarders.
Greg, tell us about our sponsors.
Where do I even start?
Well, let's start with this man over here.
Mass Monster Activewear, Ken's Radiator Service.
I like Ken.
That is an awesome place to go.
You see him with their little mohawk wigs on the other day?
You mean those were wigs?
Well, I don't know.
It
looked like wigs.
that whole section was the rowdiest section of the night.
Absolutely.
They just kept it going all night long.
You know what? Little G's Cajun Cafe, man. Just a great sponsor. Piggly Wiggly. I mean, you know, and it goes on and on.
George Grover.
Who else?
Let me see. Who else?
Keith Motts.
Keith.
Vitamins. Brian Norman's Automotive.
Baldwin Septic Tank Service.
I mean, and then today, I got a phone call. This guy calls up and says, what does it take to be a sponsor? People are wanting to jump on board. Why? Why are they calling and asking if they can? You know what? You got a call 2 weeks ago with Piggly Wiggly, didn't you?
Yep.
Is it too late to be a sponsor?
Never too late to be a sponsor. Look, what we're doing is this will be Planet Wrestling's last show of 11. But starting in 12, we got a full season. We don't like to wrestle in December and January. Them's the holiday months, and number two is hunting season.
That's right. That's what I thought it was.
You know, I mean, let's face it. You know, you got to have some time in the woods.
Take the halls and jack them goats up, right?
Got to kill the goats. But in 12, we've got a lot of things, a lot of surprises. All we're going to do is get bigger and better. And you know what? It's all about our fans.
No. We are the two biggest egomaniacs in this business. It's all about me, and it's just a little about you, but it's mostly all about me. And well, yet, Greg, you know, here in the middle, it could be a little bit about Greg. Is it a little bit about you?
Just when you bring sexy back.
Tonight we're going to bury that. No more of this. We're going to talk about our stuff. I don't care what nobody else does around here. I really don't care. I don't got to frequentize their... I'm not going to call them events. They're shows because it's like a circus. But we're going to talk about our stuff, and that's it. Show? Oh, you know, it's about us.
Well, let's talk about what happened at the last show. We had a great, great time. We gave away a really beautiful Planet Wrestling jacket, made some fans really happy. We got shirts for sale, hats for sale. We got programs with all of our wrestlers and also sponsors in it. We got...
Turbo Ted almost set himself on fire.
Oh, I thought he did set himself on fire. That itself was worth the price of the
mission. Yes, it was.
But you know what? I would have to say, we've got Planet Wrestling thongs.
Woo!
Signed by Tyrone.
Woo! Camp. That's, I mean, you know what, you gotta love that. You gotta love it. Speaking of Tyrone, Tyrone and Sugar Lips lit the place on fire, man.
Who would have thunk it?
Wherever they go, you know. I think Sugar Lips is really starting to get a following there. He had
him and his horse.
Yeah, there you go. Him and his horse. You know, Turbo Ted. You know, Turbo Ted's a veteran. You know.
Oh
yeah. Hey, let me tell you this. Chad Cheatham and Tony Sweat.
9-1-1.
Two of the biggest guys that you ever want to see.
Absolutely. Two monsters.
That can really cut a good promo.
Yes, I agree. And they took on, I have to, you know, whether you like their tactics in the squared circle or not, Kirk Matthews and a man we haven't seen around this area in some time, Minotaur.
I enjoy their tactics.
I'm sure you do.
I enjoy their tactics. As a matter of fact.
That was me and Ron. I get sick.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh, I'm invisible now.
No, you're not invisible.
Well, actually, you are.
Oh, yeah. Since we're talking about that, Max, I want you to know that Scarface is suspended.
He's not going to be suspended. The benefit of those of you that weren't there, at the end of the main event, Scarface came in, did a little interference.
Why is Scarface suspended? Is Scarface suspended?
Well, half of... this company is mine.
Well, I don't care if half this company is yours. You can't just go off
yours and suspend people whenever you feel like it.
But I don't care. Look, that is your deal. I could care less about that. You can't go off and just suspend people whenever you feel like it. You got to let me know. We got 4 days before the show.
He's not going to be there. Suspended. So you can pick somebody else. I don't care.
4 days before the show, you're going to suspend one of my biggest guys.
Yep.
There you have it. You heard it here first.
He's done. He interfered. Yeah.
Caused you to... Oh, so now, you know, this is the tactics that you're going to pull now. You're going to start crying because
I have to let the fans know he interfered after Bobby Dahl pulled out a Bob Liddell special, the brass knuckles.
Yeah, hit me in the back of my head.
I didn't hit you with no brass knuckles.
Man, you must be on some form of narcotics.
That was pure adult Jack Jaw right here. Georgia Jaw Jacker right here stole it right from
the biscuit cutter.
I got it right from him. You know what he actually
did? I saw bigger arms on the clock.
Oh, please. Please.
Let's move along. He's suspended, so...
Suspended. You can't do that.
You got to pick out you another wrestler. I think I'm going to line somebody up for you. That's what I'm going
to do. He's going to help you out.
Maybe the Black Wolf. I will call the Black Wolf and let you use him. Would you like that?
You can call the Black Panthers for all I care.
Well, let's get back to
NAACP for all I care. I don't care who you call. Your little suspension thing. You know what? You pulled a little stunt on me trying to get me in the ring, and yet you know that I am absolutely medically not cleared to wrestle.
That's right.
You know that.
And I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
We can pick you another wrestler.
You're sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You know you're sorry. All right.
You can get another wrestler to take
this spot. You know what? You're starting to piss me off.
I will find somebody. Oh, now he's going to use profanity on the television. Listen, kid, he's still listening to that. He's a very nasty man. He's angry. He's got problems. So I will try to calm him down. Don't listen to him, kid. He's bad influence. Listen to the
chief. You know what, dude? You're the one that called me over here.
Well, I'll tell you what. Let's get on to some other business. Let's talk about 911, the extinguisher Tony Sweat.
I'm going to call 911 because I'm getting run over here big
time. The original war machine, Chad Cheatham.
You know what? The guys who I brought in, guys who I called up, and they turned on me.
What can I say, kiddies? He's telling it all. Even his friends turn on him. So listen to the chief.
Listen to
Bad
the chief.
Bad influence.
And I have to say, I haven't seen Chad Cheatham in quite some time. The guy's in phenomenal
kiddies
shape.
And chief, aren't you barred from actually being around kids?
No, I'm not.
I mean, aren't you barred from being like within 30 yards of
that's
kids?
Somebody else, but we're not going to talk about that.
Oh, gosh.
Well, let's talk about 911's opponents. They took on, who was it, Nick Bondage with Alexia?
Yeah.
And who else did 911 take on?
I'm pissed off.
I know, but they won. Scarface. Regardless, they won.
Scarface,
yeah,
Waylon,
yeah, yeah. Scarface.
Accompanied to the ring by Uncle Jim.
I can't even think right now because I'm ticked off. You just bring him over here and he just throws the whole thing off for me.
Well, what can I say? The guy interfered, and that's breaking the rules. I never break the rules.
Oh, my.
I never broke the rules.
You broke more rules?
I've never.
Thank you very much. See, kiddies, once again, Cheif don't lie. Kiddies. He quit lying back in 1972.
Well, let's talk about the tag team of yourself and Ron Horn. You guys have gelled into a cohesive tag team unit.
We are the Real Steel Champions.
Oh, my God.
There's no belts, but we call ourselves the Real Steel Champions.
Yeah, you can call yourself anything you want.
What? Now, why do you want to be nasty?
I'm fed up.
Why do you got to be nasty?
I'm fed up.
What are you doing, Jim? What's this?
It means we have to wrap up this segment. We'll come back and we'll do one more segment and cover everything that happened.
I'm not coming back.
And what's coming up next for Planet Wrestling? Stick with us.